today we're here with Marc Gilpin. Marc, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. How are you doing today?
I'm having a blast.
You're having a good time?
Yeah, it's a great Giants this year.
Okay, good.
Yeah, amazing talent up there on stage.
Good. Well, I wanted to start with the beginning of your career, which started at a very early age, which I love this story. So if you could tell us how you got started. You were an actor, is that correct?
Yeah, so my first career started at 4 years old. And I started out as a model and did commercial work till about 9-10 years old. I got into feature film. Mm-hmm. About that point, I'd done over 300 commercials, regional, local, mm-hmm. national. Then I got into feature film work. Mm-hmm. Did a little movie called Where's Willie out in Kerrville, Texas. Mm-hmm. Then went on to do Jaws 2, Roy Scheider's son in that. And then it was just a battle of the teen boys out in Hollywood with all the different projects that were going on.
Right.
And continued to work well into my 20s as an actor. Mm-hmm. So I spent a greater part of my first quarter century of my life on a set. Mm-hmm. And learned all the ins and outs of what it does, what it means to make a movie.
Right. That's interesting. And so you came back to Texas. Is that right?
Yeah. I came back to Texas and decided to leave the industry for a little while. And I really wanted to just have a normal life. And mm-hmm. I wanted to just kind of see what that was like. Still wanted to be creative. Mm-hmm. And so that led me up to North Texas and studied painting and drawing mm-hmm. up there. Mm-hmm. And just loved school and loved getting into a different kind of traditional creative format.
Right. So tell us about... After you got out of school, you had already learned Photoshop, is that correct?
No, actually, while I was in college, studying for my degree, got an opportunity to intern at a small startup called the Imagination Station, mm-hmm. later became iStation.
Right.
Started out as an unpaid intern, didn't know the difference between a PC or a Mac, mm-hmm. Never used a computer, but had always had an interest in, I'm a Star Wars baby, so it was...
Right.
Oh my gosh, I'd always wanted to build the next Millennium Falcon for, whatever Star Wars might come out. Well, practical effects had given way to digital effects, and I was fascinated by that as well. Mm-hmm. And so I loved the idea of getting involved in that world, and when the opportunity came along, this startup was doing 2D animation, was looking to integrate 3D animation, and so I was their first in-house artist that they had hired outside of the creative director that was in Los Angeles. They needed somebody here mm-hmm. that could do the day-to-day stuff.
Yeah. Would you say your experience as an actor educated your intuition towards animation?
Yeah, that's a great question. Mm-hmm. I hadn't thought about it at the time, mm-hmm. but since, yes. Once you've understood the process of storytelling mm-hmm. or camera angles, and because I'm also a photographer and I do some other things, but once you've kind of got that in one area, you mm-hmm. can easily take it to another area. Mm-hmm. And you're right. So animation came very naturally to me, mm-hmm. Even though I hadn't done any of that before. Motion graphics, 2D, all that stuff. But yes, I would say all of the animation experience that I've gained definitely got off to a good start because of my film mm-hmm. background.
That's great. That's wonderful. And you're freelancing now, is that correct?
Yes, been freelancing now for about a year and a half, mm-hmm. Getting in more time with the family, which is important to me.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, mm-hmm. and getting to work on some really interesting projects. Mm-hmm. In this town, here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, I think there's opportunities to do a wide variety of things. So I might be working on a 3D animation project or motion graphic, but then out of the blue, you get a project like the one that Jay Shu and I did earlier this year where we got hired to, basically as Imagineers, if you will, we themed out an entire water park.
Absolutely.
So that's the kind of idea of what I'm talking about. In this area, you never know where you're mm-hmm. going to take your skills. Mm-hmm. You can use them in so many different mm-hmm. ways.
Do you still have the ambition to get back into film? Would you like to do some visual effects on film if the opportunity came through?
Oh, yeah. Actually, as a freelancer... I worked with my brother-in-law, Drew Dalio, who's mm-hmm. a very accomplished modeler. He pulled me in on a couple of sci-fi movies out of Hong Kong.
Oh, wow.
So I got to model and destroy a 3D earthquake-ridden city for this sci-fi film.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.
So tomorrow your class is about After Effects, and Cinema 4D. Do you want to talk a little bit about what you'll be presenting in the pipeline?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I'm calling the class the Cineware Effect. Mm-hmm. This particular tutorial that I'm giving, I'm showing how to composite live action footage with 3D animation.
I know we're excited to see it, so yeah. Do you have any advice, any parting words of wisdom for students that are getting into the industry today?
You know, I'm a Generation Xer, mm-hmm. and having come from that group of people, I am just so impressed with the 20-somethings and younger right now that are so focused on doing what they want to do in life. Mm-hmm. You know, I think the American dream that we've been sold for the last 50 years, this generation is realizing that those kinds of ideals, hook up with a company for 20 years, 30 years, hopefully retire, then get to have fun in your 60s, all of that it's not true. It's mm-hmm. not going to happen. And so they're going forward in life today mm-hmm. with the focus on being, I'm going to do what I know is going to make me happy, and I'm going to pursue a work-life balance from the get-go. And my advice is to never forget that. Mm-hmm. It's so true that you have to learn to answer to yourself first, mm-hmm. And then everything else will fall in place, and you'll be a lot happier. So I more than giving advice, I really applaud the way students today are kind of tackling that question of what am I going to do with my life and my career. I think mm-hmm. they're off to a really good start.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you, Marc. I appreciate you coming out.
Thank you, Mamie. Glad to be here.
Thanks.